And we're actually at a point in robotics where robots are kind of moving out of these very controlled environments, like either laboratories, but factories and warehouses. And in those environments, we can dictate everything down to the most minute detail, which means that we can design those areas around robots and then have people just kind of doing what they need to do to work in the space that was designed around the robots. Now we're working with robots that want to go into places that are designed around people. These are robots that are designed to work in human populated spaces. These are things that are designed to work alongside people. And at that point, you really don't have the option of coercing the environment to be what's best for the robot. So you have to test your robot in a scenario that more closely emulates what it's going to look like when it goes into the real world.
I'm primarily working on using AI methods, planning and learning to create service robots. In the future, if you ask your service robot to bring you an apple, it needs to sort of reason about where those things are and actually plan the actions to complete that task. To do that, there are like really like many components that would have to work together. One specific problem I have worked on is you say you want an apple, but the robot hasn't seen an apple in your home recently. But it knows that, okay, it's an apple, it's a fruit, so it's probably in the kitchen, and there's a fridge in the kitchen, there are some counters, or if you have like a cabinet where you usually store fruits, and it should go look there. Being able to reason about hypothetical object and plan the actions to look for the apple is something we specifically looked at.
People are very good at passing each other in tightly constrained, you know, busy with lots of people areas. Like if you walk past someone in the hallway, what you don't have to do is verbally say, hey, I'm gonna walk to my right. And if you walk to your right, then we'll pass each other on each other's left-hand sides. So everything will work out. People don't do that. They look at each other's gaze and each other's body language in order to do that. So what we did is we took a robot and we put a head on it, like a virtual agent, 3D rendered robot head that was put onto the front of the robot with computer monitor. And all we had to do is when it passes people in our simulated hallway is look to the direction that it intends to walk. And people automatically understood. They walked naturally out of the robot's path because the robot was looking where it was going to go, and they walked out of the robot's path. So what we found is that by emulating that human behavior, the robots actually were able to more effectively pass people in crowded areas like that. And so I look at a lot of problems like that where it's like, what do the people do? Can I put it onto the robot? And if I put it onto the robot, does the robot do this thing better?
The Army-focused robotics research that's happening here at UT is all sort of under a cohesive program called the Robotics Center of Excellence here at UT. All of the work has been identified as being relevant to the Army's modernization priorities. So there's lots of work, lots of energy right now in the Army behind putting together a next generation combat vehicle. So the combat vehicles that the Army has had them for a very long time. And we'd like to get new modern combat vehicles out there and fielded. And one part of that vision is to actually have a robotic combat vehicle, which can exhibit some level of autonomy. If a vehicle can do that, then we can keep our human soldiers much safer by not putting them out in the world where we don't know where an enemy might be or what their intentions would be.
I don't think that there's ever been a time that has been faster paced and more exciting for artificial intelligence and robotics than right now. Historically, advances in technology have made society better. In particular, advances in robotics are going to enable people to, you know, just lead fuller lives. If you think about people who may, you know, be an aging population who might need to move into an assisted care facility, they might be able to maintain more independence because there are robots in their home helping them take care of their day-to-day chores, their day-to-day tasking. If you think about autonomous vehicles, you know, you may have more independence in the way that we transport ourselves in the next few years. It might be perfectly reasonable to send an autonomous vehicle off to take your children to school, as opposed to you driving the vehicle to go to school. It might be reasonable to send an autonomous vehicle to go pick up your groceries instead of picking up groceries yourself, or even having them delivered, right? It might be reasonable to have a robot that cleans your home or cooks things for you. And then when you think about, just that overall impact on making your life easier or assisting you or helping you to concentrate on the things that you think are important, I think that that's a really, really great thing.
I envision a time when there's a transition from with robots that we've had with computers, right? There was a time not all that long ago when people thought of computers as, big mainframe pieces of equipment that take up an entire room, that you wouldn't need more than a handful of computers in any given country, or maybe even in the world, that they'd be big enough and powerful enough to do all of the computing. And there was a revolution around personal computing, and then eventually even towards mobile computing, where now we all carry around computers in our pockets that are, if we have a smartphone and there's laptops and there's computers everywhere. And I think, that right now we're still in the, in that phase where robots are not, in everybody's home. They're sort of they're special purpose. They're used in industrial settings more than in the sort of open world, but eventually I think that's going to change. That we will get to a point where there are robots just among us and in our homes and in our buildings, and we're trying to pave the way towards that.